Well, hello. Peabody here. Polymath, gadabout, and temporal voyageur. And this is my boy, Kevin. Say hello, Kevin.
Hello. The Wayback Machine is up and running, Mr. Peabody. Where are we going today?
Italy. Pisa, to be specific. In the year 1616. Where we'll make the acquaintance of that brilliant scientist known as Galileo.
Now, where did they go?
The moons of Jupiter, signore?
No, all of my so-called friends. They left me high and dry.
What happened, Mr. Galileo?
All I did was flip a flop of the sun and the Earth.
Thereby confirming Copernicus's heliocentric theory, and proving that Earth is just another planet orbiting the sun.
Giustamente! And now I'm as popular as a cockroach in a pizzeria. I can't even continue my work. Me patrona want to return my calls.
Ah, yes, your patroness, the wealthy and powerful Grand Duchess Christina.
Christina, si. Without her lira, I've got the belle niente. Nothing. Nada. Zippo.
I'll bet Mr. Peabody could convince her to help you again.
But the Grand Duchess, she will listen to none but the most brilliant thinkers in all Italia.
Mr. Peabody is the most brilliant thinker of them all. He speaks 19 languages, and he's an inventor and an athlete and...
Now, Kevin, nobody likes a braggart. But my boy is quite correct. I am conversant in topics ranging from alchemy to zoology.
Ah, a real uomo universale.
I'm a dog, signore, not an uomo. But yes, I am rather universale, and I should be happy to speak with Her Highness on your behalf. Come, Kevin. And so we sought out the palazzo of the Grand Duchess herself, only to find that someone else already had Christina's ear, Galileo's formidable rival, Cardinal Bellarmine.
So, you see, Holy Scripture itself requires a geocentric universe. The 93rd Psalm clearly states, the world is firmly established, it cannot be moved.
Unlike my bocce ball, lucky shot, Your Eminence.
Twas my shot, Your Highness, and I assure you, luck was not involved. Allow me to introduce myself, Peabody, world champion lawn bowler and man of science, and my boy Kevin. Fetch, Kevin.
Man of a science, eh? I suppose you're in a cahoots with that heretic Galileo. Well, beware. Neither man nor dog has ever defied the Holy Catholic Church.
That's not what Herr Luther's dachshund told me. And surely you don't take all the psalms literally.
Are you and Galileo so brazen as to deny the truth of a scripture itself?
Galileo believes that the Holy Bible can never speak untruth, whenever its true meaning is understood. But scripture must be understood by everyone. From the Grand Duchess?
I say, is this dog talking?
To my boy, Kevin.
That's right, Mr. Peabody.
And so, the Bible must sometimes speak so that the unlearned may understand. But nature doesn't care if it's understood. It can but obey the laws God gives it.
Like the law of gravity, right, Mr. Peabody?
Quiet, you. I'm not going to explain that until later in the lecture. The point is, Highness, both scripture and nature come from God, but with, say, astronomy, we ought to start with what our eyes and Professor Galileo's telescope tell us. Don't you think?
The talk hound is correct. Galileo shall have his ducats. Now bring me a calzone! It's 2 minutes past my lunchtime!
And so Bellarmine went off to lick his wounds, and the Grand Duchess decided to resume her patronage of Galileo.
Grazie. Mille grazie, my friends. Now I can continue my experiments.
What are you trying to prove now?
That the two objects of a different weight, dropped at the same time, will fall at the same speed.
Try these, signore.
I don't get it, Mr. Peabody. If Mr. Galileo was right, why did the church end up convicting him of heresy?
It's simple enough, Kevin. Sometimes, that's just the way the ball bounces.